So here are the filaments in your typical house fuse, 15 and 20 amp. And see how tiny the filament is in the fuse we put in the cassette deck. It's recording.
Recording.
Yeah, good.
Okay, so take a look at that and see if you see any overcurrent protection in the fire safety.
Nothing. There's not nothing. 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 Not at all.
Okay, so we're gonna...
The reason why we put this fuse in this is because this transformer, if something shorts out, one of the regulators in our rectifier diodes on the bridge rectifier, the transformer here can get really hot and cause this cord to start getting warm, and it can cause the fire, or the it could get so warm and cause the fire on the carpet or drape or wherever it's laying across. And the fuse on there will keep that from happening.
The plug is not polarized?
The plug is not polarized.
Yes. Yes, so I'm going
to put some on.
You want to put your finger here and hold this wire so it stays straight?
Well, just like that.
Yeah.
You don't have this thing completely tight, right?
No, I mean, do that.
can see the side, there's no edge.
That's good. Okay, so now we can do that wire. Other end I'm not going to do.
No.
Can I put that a little bit?
Ready style of electronics and everything. Version.
Okay, that's going to sit perfect. Okay.
Wire for something else, yep. No waste it. No wasting. This way, right? Recording. I didn't hear it go bang.
Yeah, they went
bang. Didn't hear it go bang. Sounds good. Bang, bang, bang. Tighten it up.
We use a wrench here to tighten this up.
Thank you.
went up if you went the right way.
Yes.
Righty tighty, lefty loosey. That's the angle, baby. Someone's calling my phone. Cell phone ringing, but it's great. Got it up. Right now, I do it. Somebody be calling me, but anyway. At this time of night. I think you're good.
Okay, zip ties.
Bump in beyond the fuse?
Yes.
Right now?
Not yet.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, so we're
going to... I was going to say if you wanted to, like, do... I don't know if you wanted to do that together with that one, or if you want to tie it to the side here. I don't know.
I was thinking about it all together.
Yeah, that would look good. That would look better. That would look better. I'll hold them together if you want me to. Yeah, it looks good that way. Looks better that way. Yes, it does. Okay, good.
And then we should set this back away from the metal transformers.
And moving parts and everything.
Okay, we'll do that. Do you want to John put in the fuse?
Yep.
Out?
Mm-hmm. Turn it so the camera can see it here.
Okay.
Susan, this is a 750 million. We use these 1-amp fuses, but we don't have any right now. So,
let's show them what can short out and cause the fire without having a line fuse in there.
Okay, well, let's see. These regulators right here can short out, or this one doesn't have a bridge rectifier. It's got the separate diodes. For the bridges, these can short out and cause the fire too. That's why we do this. And make sure you always consult an authorized service center before doing the work, which I am, because you can actually make a problem by doing it the wrong way.
Okay, so not just the rectifiers going bad, start the fire, but draw a lot of current and overheat the transformer. As the transformer is getting hot, it can start drawing more than amperage than what the sport is rated for, and that's what would start the fire in your house if this shorts out. Sparks and catches a drape or something on fire. Alrighty. Peace. There's my solder connection on the circuit board. Here is my solder connection on the fuse block. And the other side of the fuse block.